if you want to make game art with vector software, to me one of the best sources for inspiration is pixel art. I've always said that pixel art and vector art are two sides of the same coin, and they actually mesh surprisingly well. If you learn how to transform a pixel art tileset into working vector assets, you'll have an unlimited source of study material and easy to create art. And in this video, I'll show you exactly how to do that. The first mistake people make, and one I definitely made myself, is trying to copy the art pixel by pixel. That never looks good. Pixel art is symbolic. Those noisy clusters are just hints of detail that your brain interprets as texture. In vector art, we have to communicate that information explicitly. So before redrawing, ask yourself, what's the form and purpose behind this element, and how can I represent it with simpler, more deliberate shapes? Remember, you're not tracing, you are interpreting. Vector art is all about clean, well-defined shapes. So a great starting point is to identify the biggest shapes and recreate those first. Most of the time, your shapes won't match the pixel version one-to-one, and that's okay. You have to get comfortable losing some of those little stair-step edges. If you try to copy every tiny side implied by the pixels, it won't look good. Focus on the main silhouette, and embrace the switch from implied detail to explicit clarity. Some tiles, especially dirt, ground, and sand, use a lot of noise to fake detail. Don't try to replicate that by using image textures, it never translates well. Of course, you could push the boundaries and turn it into a super detailed illustration, but if your goal is to make effective game art, it's better to skip all those tiny details. Instead, go for bigger, simpler shapes with less textural information. A few overlapping blobs, subtle gradients, and tone variations can imply any surface if used in a clever way. This one is a bit of a continuation from my previous point. Use reference if you have problems figuring out how to adapt something. Go to Pinterest and search for vector game art or something like that. You'll find tons of examples of vector games made by the pros. You're bound to find something that helps you with some difficult to translate asset. You might not find an exact one-to-one reference, but if you're observant, you'll see patterns you can apply. How they handled rocks, trees, or sand, and what shapes they used to communicate that information. This one is important. When adapting to vector form, you'll often need to change or even add elements that weren't in the original pixel art. For example, you may find it looks better with outline art. Vector art often shines without outlines. Or maybe you discovered a new color scheme you like, like adding this pure black shadow I used here. Those creative choices can completely transform a tileset that didn't work before. So don't be afraid to change the style entirely. Use the pixel reference as a starting point, not a rulebook. Your goal isn't to make a one-to-one copy, it's to learn from it and create something new. Just do try to keep your style consistent across all your assets, like with any other illustration. A quick tip, forget about tile maps. You can still use them if your project needs it, but since you're making HD art, you most likely don't want to limit yourself to a strict tile grid. Sometimes forcing everything to fit perfectly into tiles just makes things harder. Instead, focus on making good shapes that connect naturally, even if they break the grid a little. And here is the final tip. If you really want to master drawing in Inkscape, not just for game art, but also characters, backgrounds, and more, I have a bundle with 13 full Inkscape courses designed for beginners. It'll take you from zero to being able to draw anything you want. If you're especially interested in game art, the bundle includes two full courses focused entirely on that topic, including how to build tile maps from scratch. You'll find the link in the description below. That's it for now, thanks for watching, and if you found this helpful, leave a like and comment letting me know what you think, or if you have other tips for adapting pixel art to vector. See you in the next one, bye!